Joan Crawford, who rose from a chorus girl to one of the top stars of the golden age of movies, died today of a heart attack at her Manhattan home.
Joan Crawford lived as a recluse in her white-carpeted Park Avenue apartment.
Crawford dead in her Manhattan apartment, apparently from a heart attack.
Joan Crawford was found dead in her Manhattan apartment today, apparently of a heart attack.
Her career virtually spanned the history of the movies.
To all of us who watch this glamorous, self-assured woman in the dark movie houses of our little towns, she represented the very best there was.
She left the world of glamour and dancing in 1945 when she showed her dramatic abilities in the movie Mildred Pierce.
Her career was long, the money was good. Miss Crawford began to know how to invest it, and she eventually became a very successful businesswoman.
Joan Crawford, who has four adopted children, mixed business and pleasure with her last marriage to Alfred Steele of Pepsi-Cola.
Steele, who died in 1959, was board chairman of the Pepsi-Cola company, and his widow became a director of that firm after his death.
A maid found her body this morning. Movie star Joan Crawford, dead of an apparent heart attack.
She had no history of serious ailments before her death of a heart attack this morning.
You know, at one point she told an interviewer, "I always felt that if you're going to be a star, you have to act like a star." And Joan Crawford did, and she was.
If it be your will that I speak no more, and my voice be still as it was.
What do you look forward to?
Oh, about 100 years to learn how to paint. 100 years to learn the education, to have the education, the formal education I never had. I never went beyond the sixth grade.
Yours is one of the classic American rags to riches stories, may I say?
Well, rags.
Well, I would suggest riches as well. Your early childhood must have, in fact,
yes,
made you into
yes.
Certain sort of actress.
We were very, very poor.
From this broken hill, I will sing to you. From this broken hill, all your praises they shall ring.
You're a very determined person, aren't you? I'd want to know why you're such a determined person.
To let me sing. If it be your will, if there is a choice, let the rivers fill. Let your mercy spill on all these burning hearts in hell.
Who do you think has been luckier in life? The audiences who have had the tremendous pleasure of watching all your splendid performances, or yourself for being given the gift to give this talent to people?
I am, because they write to me. And through the years, I write about 10,000 or 12,000 letters a month to my friends. I never call them fans. And when you realize throughout the world that you reach this many people and that they feel a friendship for you, and they write year after year, then I feel I'm the lucky one to have found this many friends.
One thing that she was most of all was a movie star. She played that role 24 hours a day.
The closer the camera came, the more relaxed she was. The more she showed a seductive side. She showed her heart, she showed everything to the camera. No lover, no husband ever saw that side. It was more melting, more interesting than anything she showed in real life.
Let the rivers fill.
The thought occurs to me again that we've pretty much covered your world of reality, the world of illusion, of what you are, of what you must be, anything in life that you want that you haven't had? Are you satisfied fully?
I wouldn't live it any differently if I had it to live over again. At the same time, I must say that I have no personal life, and it is a lonely life.
She was lonely. She was lonely. It was almost as though Joan Crawford was trying to escape sitting down with Lucille Lesueur and say, where are we really, and what do we want?
The enemy is not something unknown and vague. It's cancer. In the ranks of love.